Good morning, 9D. Welcome to the class. I hope you all are fine, you all are healthy. Okay, let's begin up with the class for today. Are you all able to hear my voice? Thank you so much. Kindly switch on the camera, everyone. Kindly switch on your camera. Nindy, you are requested. Kindly on the camera, those who have not done. Sukhdeep, Krishna, Himani, Harleen Kaur. Okay, so this is the second class of physics. In the previous class, we covered the syllabus, the blueprint, fine, the general discussion all about physics. Now we are going to proceed on with the class. I want you all to kindly have your notebook and a pen along with you. Please have your notebook and a pen along with you. Prithpal, Harleen, please switch on the camera. Shivansh ji, done? Chale, okay. I'm going to share the screen and we are going to proceed on with the class. So we are going to start with the chapter motion. That is the first chapter we are going to have in physics. Fine? We are going to proceed on with motion chapter. My first question to you is, we are going to understand the name of the chapter first of all. What is motion? My first question is, what is motion? So anybody, if you have any idea, please raise your hand. Yes, Shivansh. Good morning, madam.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, dear.
Yes, MMD motion is movement of any object.
Yes, the movement of any object is what we say motion. Very correct. Okay, now I'll be giving you one example to just explain this more. Fine, so if you don't have any idea about it, get an idea. Okay, so your eyes onto the screen, please. Let's say this is a rock, fine, a big rock, and a person is there standing nearby this rock over here, let's say at this particular position, fine. You want to find out that what is the distance, like you want to check whether the person is in motion or in rest. So what you will do, you will find out the distance between the person and the rock. First, the distance is 3 meters. After few seconds, you again check the distance. Now the distance between person and the rock is going to be 4 meters. After few minutes again, you check the distance. Now it is 7 meters. Every time the distance keep on changing. It means the person keep on changing its position. Understood? Now, suppose the same thing You check for the first time the distance between the person and the object. It comes to be 3 meters. After again 5 seconds, you checked, it is still 3 meters. Again after 5 minutes, you checked, it is still 3 meters. So is the person moving? No, the person is not moving. Fine. So whenever you have to check whether the object is moving or not moving, you have to compare it with something. Fine. For example, if I want to know about whether the student is in rest or motion, I may compare it with the door, the entrance door, fine, or any object nearby. Now, if your distance from the door is same at every point of time, every time, after 5 minutes, after 10 minutes, after 15 minutes, I check, you are at the same distance from the door. It means you are not moving. But if your distance keep on changing, it means you are moving. That means you are in motion. Is this clear? Okay. Yes, Adarsh, is this clear, beta? Okay. Now, this rock. With which I have compared the person to find out whether it is in motion or rest. आप किसी एक पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट के साथ कंपेयर करोगे. फाइन. सो दैट इज व्हाट वी से रेफरेंस पॉइंट. क्लियर? रेफरेंस पॉइंट इज दैट विद विच वी आर गोइंग टू कंपेयर टू फाइंड आउट वेदर द ऑब्जेक्ट इज इन मोशन और वेदर द ऑब्जेक्ट इज इन रेस्ट. ओके. ओके. Now I'm going to talk about two things, and we are going to use these two words randomly in the class. So this is the name of the chapter. Okay. Okay. So the first word is initial position, and the second is final position. Himani, what are you doing, beta? Okay, so the first word is initial position and the second word is final position. A little from the name is clear to you. Fine. Let's talk about this to make it more clear. Let's say this is object A, this particular object. Fine. And this is somewhere object B. Okay. Let's say object A is your home and object B is your school. Fine. And you have to go from home to school. Yes. You want to go to school? Chal. We are waiting for you. We'll meet soon. Okay. So this is your home, object one. Then second position is your school. You have to go from your home to your school. Now from where you are going to begin? From where we begin? From this point, home. This is called your initial position. This is called initial position. Initial position means from where you are going to begin, from where you are going to start. Fine, we call it as initial position. And the second one, you reach school. So school is your final position. From where you are going to start, that is your initial position. Where you will end, that is your final position. Are the words clear? Krishna, I am requesting again. Krishna, Harsimran, Arman, Shopreet,